Hi everyone, this is a reading with me. I hope you are doing well. This is for all star signs. If you are here, I feel like, you know, it's a sign that there are messages for you. And I also wanted to mention as well that this is a safe space where you are always, always very welcome as well. Always, you know, personal tarot readings with me, services, rituals, items, which are handmade, meditative and sage, and, you know, services are always listed down below on shopmoonlightguidance.com and in the description box. And there are thousands of 5-star reviews if you're ever interested. Gonna have a look and see what is coming through for this reading for you and what messages I can give to you. So let's have a look and see. Okay, so I feel like you're very in your head right now about something. I feel like this is very much actually connected to someone. So with the Seven of Cups, you're very much in your head. Temperance shows that you're waiting for some kind of action, okay, to be taken. And this action comes from someone who is not emotionally as present. They're not really doing enough towards you. We see that here with the Page of Cups and the Moon. You feel like this person just needs to be a lot more forward. They need to communicate. They need to emotionally express their feelings to you. And you feel like you're kind of in the limbo. You're in limbo land where you literally feel like, how low can you go? Well, not exactly, but it's more so in the sense limbo, just feeling like you're stuck, right? Feeling like, are they going to do anything? Are they not? Should I stay? Should I go? Should I wait? Should I not? Limbo land, okay? And it frustrates you, you know, it really frustrates you because you're waiting for action to come from this person's side and you are emotionally frustrated that this person's not doing enough, they're not saying enough, they're not being proactive enough. And it's confusing, it's frustrating, it's annoying. And more than anything, it's so annoying. You literally feel like, come on, hello, you doing anything? Yes or no? And then we've also got as well the Star. Okay, so the Star definitely does show here that this person is going to come forward, which is interesting. This person does seem to be emotionally not as available as you, so they have a habit of keeping their emotions to themselves, they have a habit of suppressing their emotions, they have a habit of sometimes getting confused themselves and not knowing what exactly to do. They tend to have a habit of just feeling very frustrated and not knowing like how to go about things, what to do, what to say. Emotionally unavailable basically. And what's really interesting is that right now you're sort of like waiting for them to come forward. Right now you're anticipating for them to come forward. They are going to come forward. We saw that with the Star. But what's really interesting is that you're going to get to a point where you honestly just think to yourself, like, enough is enough. Like, I just can't be bothered. I can't be bothered to like continuously expend all of my emotional energy towards someone who's like doing the bare minimum, right? And it's when you're kind of in that mindset, especially with the Queen of Pentacles, when you are so like strong and confident, here we go, strength card as well, and you're so strong and confident that you think to yourself, like, wait a second, who are you like to keep me waiting, you know? And you just think to yourself, I'm gonna live my life, I'm gonna live my best life, I'm gonna take care of myself, like, I'm gonna just let them do whatever the hell they're doing, but I don't want to give my emotional energy to this person constantly. That seems to spiritually trigger them to want to come forward. It spiritually triggers them to say something. They start to feel like something energetically in you has changed, and basically their tricks don't work anymore, okay? So if you, for example, are looking over their social media and they always show to be having a great time and you just feel like, oh, like, why are you not doing anything towards me? Or why are you not taking me out or spending time with me? And then you get frustrated, you know, like, hello, I am here as well. Well, they will start to feel like they got to do something towards you. They will start to feel really bad. They will start to feel frustrated. They will feel like, oh my God, I actually need to progress things along with you, move things along with you. What am I doing? Is what they will literally think to themselves. Okay, and it does. It triggers them to come forward with a Six of Wands and also the Ten of Pentacles. Like, their tricks don't work anymore. I do feel like right now they sort of feel like you're wrapped around their fingers, okay? They're not exactly scared to lose you at this very point in time because they feel like you're somewhat still there. You're somewhat still thinking about them. They can kind of pick up spiritually, and people can pick up spiritually when you're like really thinking heavily about them. But if it's too much attachment, they then kind of just focus on other things. They don't really come forward. But when you kind of don't really care about them and you're caring more about yourself because they're literally doing the bare minimum, they're not even doing anything, right? it triggers them to feel like they've truly lost you, because they have. They've lost your spiritual energy. You're no longer thinking about them so much. So basically, when you stop doing so much towards them energetically and you start placing that energy towards yourself, it makes them feel like they've lost you. It triggers them to come towards you. It's basically what happens. Yep. And their tricks don't work. They then don't feel like you're wrapped around their fingers anymore, and it makes them uncomfortable. Okay, this entire time they've been so comfortable thinking, like, you know what, you'll come running back to me, you'll come chasing after me. No. No, those tricks don't work anymore, because you found your self-confidence, you found your self-worth, you're starting to feel better and stronger in your own energy. You're no longer running after them. It doesn't interest you, it doesn't make you feel good anymore. So 10 of Wands with the Ace of Wands as well, like, it's just not working. Like, you know, like, this kind of goes for both of you. Like, on one hand, like, this has been your energy, right, where you're kind of thinking to yourself, like, oh, I feel like not good, I want them to come forward. But then what's going to happen is you will find that confidence and power within yourself to put this behind you, and then boom, they will start to feel like they've lost you and they need to do something. It's like the tables basically turn, is what I'm seeing, right? Tables literally turning, because they don't feel like they've got your energy anymore, and they're like, whoa, what's happening? What are you up to? What are you doing? Who are you hanging out with? Okay, it makes them feel like they've lost a blessing. And what do people do when they often feel like they've lost a blessing? They want that thing back. When don't want becomes can't have, that's when people change their ways, okay? I have known people who have never, like, they've grown up hating sweet food, okay? But when they get older and suddenly the doctor says, you know what, you kind of got to take care, like, just, you know, avoid all sweet stuff, suddenly they want it 10 times more, okay? Even though they may have grown up never really craving that kind of food, like, suddenly when you get told you can't have something, you often want it 10 times more, okay? It's one of those things psychologically. If, you know, when it comes from your own personal choice and decision, it can feel affirming, but when someone says, like, actually, you know what, you can't have this, that's when you actually think, like, what? But I must have it. It's one of those things. And that's the thing that happens with this person, is that, you know, they feel like this entire time they've had a choice to kind of keep you at arm's length. But when they don't have that choice anymore, that's when they start to really panic. Okay, when they don't have your energy anymore, they start to panic. When don't want becomes cannot have, that's when the tables turn. And that's exactly what I see happening in this situation, because they're going to be like, oh my God, he is what's happening. Okay, so put yourself first, look after yourself. As always, you know, I have the detachment ritual, which really allows you to detach. Remember, the key to the law of attraction is detachment. Law of attraction means knowing what you want, being okay without it, healing, acceptance, pulling that energy towards yourself so that your manifestations take place. Okay, so yeah, if anyone's ever interested, all of the private, you know, rituals, services, items, all that good stuff, always on my website, shopmoonlightguidance.com. It's always there. Okay, I'm just going to look at these message cards, but everything's linked down below. We've got maybe. So, you know, things are not over in this situation. Things can still progress, but, you know, it's kind of in limbo land right now, as we saw. We know what's going to happen, though. So we say, see here, do you think about me too? Because they do still think about you. You're not unheard or unseen. 1-1, this love scares me. So they're a little bit scared of it right now, which is why, again, there's sort of like limbo land. They also don't feel like you're going to go anywhere. So they're not scared to completely lose you, but they are kind of scared of the connection and how deep it is and how they're like, oh my God, this is like a lot. Gossip only hurts more. That would resonate with you in the way that it resonates with you, because I feel like this reading is general, but it will resonate with you in some form of way. We have a lot of ones here as well, as you can see, 111. Ones mean take care of yourself, okay? Put yourself first, look after yourself, and the universe will literally shape itself around you, and then this opening will happen between you both, because the tables are going to turn. And that is the affirmation for this reading. If it resonates with you, comment down below. The tables are turning. That's the affirmation for your reading. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below. Check out the description box below for information on personal services, readings, items, rituals, all that good stuff. I also have TikTok and Instagram if anyone is ever interested. Instagram is moonlight.guidance. TikTok is moonlightguidance. Post short readings on there every day and have done for many years. And I'll see you all very, very soon. And take care, everyone. And put yourself first. 1111. You are number one. Bye.